StrayAllDay.com.
The Super You. Unlock and live with your highest possible level of confidence. DreAllDay.com. Dre Baldwin, DreAllDay.com. This video is about convincing. How do you convince people to do what you want them to do, or to agree with you, or to go along with your plan, or to get out of your way, or allow you to do whatever it is you want to do? I get asked about this often. Players, an athlete will ask me, how do I convince my coach to let me play this position, but he has me playing this position? How do I convince my parents or something? How do I convince people to buy my product? How do I convince somebody to agree with me? How do I convince people to co-sign my ideas? I want you to understand something. Trying to convince people is not the path you need to be on. That's the wrong plan, trying to convince people of anything. I'm gonna tell you why you don't need to be convincing anyone of anything in your life. And if you find yourself spending energy and time trying to convince people, you're in the wrong place, you're doing the wrong thing, you're approaching it with the wrong psychology, the wrong mindset. That's what I'm gonna talk about here in this video. Number one thing you gotta understand is, don't try to convince people to do things. What you need to do is find people who are already convinced and deal with them. Let's say that one more time. This is important. You don't need to try to convince people of anything. You need to find people who are already convinced and deal with them. Now, you may be asking, well, Dre, what if, you know, I'm dealing with a certain individual and I need this individual to agree with me, but they're not convinced? What am I supposed to do then? Am I supposed to go try to find another individual? I can. I'm stuck with this individual, whoever this person is, my teacher, my coach, my dad, my wife, my husband, my kids, whoever they happen to be. What you need to do then at that point, because then you can use this metaphorically, is take something that they are convinced of, something that you do agree with them on, and then you work from that point to turn them to whatever it is you want to get them to. Now, this is going to take a little bit of mental power from you. It's going to take a little bit of time you need to spend thinking about how you're going to use this, because this is not going to be just wrapped in a gift box. Okay, just do this, this, and this, and say exactly this, and everything's going to work out. It's not the way life works. You probably understand that by now, because there's a million videos on YouTube probably telling you how to talk to people and influence, and none of those is just going to be this black and white, just do this, one, two, three, and abracadabra, everything's going to work out. So what you need to do is find who or what is already convinced, who is already convinced, or what someone's already convinced of. Work from that common ground and then move around. So if you're a business person running a business, you don't need to convince people to buy your product. You need to find people who already love your product, who are already co-signing your product and using your product and giving your product positive reviews, and you need to get them to be the people who spread the word. Let them spread the word to the people who are not quite sure, the people who are trying to figure it out, because they're not going to believe you anyway. The people who are not sure are not going to believe you, because they know you have a vested interest. You're trying to sell something. The people who already bought it, listen, they are already bought in. They already bought something. They don't have anything to gain from just telling you, yo, it's actually good. Let them work for you. So if you're trying to convince a person and they're not agreeing with you on a certain topic, find something that you do agree with this person on. And then from there, you need to draw the lines from the point that we do agree on to the point that we haven't been agreeing on. If you got to go in different directions and kind of connect the dots, that's your job. That is a mental job. You need to think about it. You need to strategize and plan. You can figure out how to do it, but you got to invest the time and energy into actually thinking. Most people don't invest time into thinking, which is why they can't figure out their problems. Number two. We've all heard the phrase that a man convinced against his will is of the same opinion still. Heard that before, right? Therefore, even if you were to get really good, if I was to make you a video and say, this is exactly what you need to do to convince anybody of anything, even though it would work in the short term, I may be able to convince you of anything if I talk for long enough and it sounds good enough here on this video. An hour from now, 2 weeks from now, a year from now, you're going to go right back to what you were thinking before I convinced you. Because someone, when you convince someone that they don't want to be convinced, but you just are just such a good talker. You ever hear somebody online, maybe myself, anybody else that you listen to, a podcaster, a writer, a video maker, who's just such a good talker. They just so good, so slick with their words that they can convince anybody of anything. They can talk circles around anybody. You ever seen anybody like that? Even though they may convince you and get you to agree with them in the moment because they're just such a good talker that you can't talk them down, you're gonna go right back to thinking the same thing as soon as you're not around them anymore. It's kind of like Chris Rock said, was it Chris Rock? Chris Tucker said in Friday, right? He said, Debo be like, shut the fuck up. And he's like, I'll be quiet. When he tell me shut the fuck up, as soon as he leave, I'll be talking again. It's the exact same thing. Like, Debo was able to convince him to shut the fuck up in the moment, but as soon as he walks away, he gonna go right back to feeling however he felt before Debo was standing there. It's the same thing when you try to convince people. So trying to convince people is the wrong game. It's a waste of time, it's a waste of energy, and it does not have lasting effects. You want people to really agree with you in the long run, so when you're not even around, they still agree with what whatever it is you want them to be agreed with. You convince somebody, all they're going to do is turn into headaches for you. You convince someone, all they're going to do is you're going to be like, yo, you agree with me. I convinced you. I influenced you back then. And they're like, no, I changed my mind. I don't feel that way anymore. Or they got some brand new reason why they're not convinced anymore. All that is a waste of time for you. So don't even play that game. Number three, when you have time in the game, those of you who are trying to convince anybody of anything, when you have time in your game, whatever your game is of a proven track record, like I talked about a few videos ago, you don't need to convince anybody of anything because your work speaks for itself. Now, if you don't have any work to speak for you, then what you need to do is work on your game. Like it says right here on this hat, you got to put the work in. You got to build the track record. You got to prove yourself. See, the more proven you are, people, the less you need to convince anybody of anything. See, when your product is proven and your product could be your work, it could be a service that you offer. It could be an actual goods that you sell to people, physical goods, digital goods, ideas, whatever it is. When your product is good and it's proven, you don't have to convince anyone. It doesn't mean everybody's going to want it. Doesn't mean everybody's going to buy it. But the people who do want it, the people who it is for, who do want to buy it, you ain't got to say nothing to them because they're going to go get it when your product is proven. But you got to prove your product and build the track record. Work on your game. You got to work on your game in order to get that proven track record. If you don't have that proven track record yet, it is your job to keep doing the work. Point number four, when you are new, let's say you don't have a track record. You don't have anything proven. You don't have anything to show anybody that would convince them of anything. So you can't influence a single human being on this planet, maybe not even yourself right now. What do? You convince by providing value. So whatever value is very relative, people. Value for one person might be $1 million. Value for another person might be, yo, sweep the floor, sweep the curb outside of my pizza shop. Provide value to somebody and you become convincing because you're convincing them, I'm worthy of this position. I'm worthy of your time. I'm worthy of your attention. Maybe I'm worthy of your money. I'm worthy of your trust to give me a bigger job because I've proven myself on this job. As soon as you prove yourself on a small thing, what have you built? Track record. Now you got a track record. You've done this one thing. Okay, give me a bigger job. Okay, give me a bigger job. Okay, give me more things that I can do. So every time you prove yourself, even on the smallest thing, you are building a track record. You are building a little bit of trust. It's a little bit of trust you're establishing with that person. Now they're going to trust you a little bit more and a little bit more. You keep expanding that, but you got to keep putting the work in and you got to keep proving yourself with every opportunity that you get. For example, you're watching this video. I'm building a track record, letting you know, yo, this is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm bringing to the table. This is how it's going to be. It's for you or it's not. Is it yes or no? If it's not, it's all good. If it is, that's great. I'm going to serve the people that it is for. You're going to trust it. You're going to come to expect it. Then I may expand a little bit more. Now I'm going to do a little bit more. Now I'm going to do a little bit more. And that's how you build a track record. You got to start small, prove yourself, and then keep proving yourself with every opportunity that you get. When it was a story I read, I heard Puff Daddy was talking about how he met Notorious B.I.G. And when he met B.I.G., Puff was a little bit, his name was starting to come up. He was starting to be known because he was a quality tastemaker. He had helped launch the careers of several artists and they were successful. So when Big met Puff and Puff asked him, you know, what you trying to do? Like, where are you trying to go with this? And Big said, look, I want to do whatever you want me to do. Whatever you tell me to do, I'm going to do it so we can get this money. Because I don't want to go back to the streets. I don't want to keep selling drugs. I don't want to get killed out here in the street. Whatever you want me to do to get this money, I'll do it. Now, Big wasn't going to say that to just anybody. He was saying that to Puff because Puff had a proven track record. It wasn't a long track record, but it was proven. The few opportunities he had maximized those opportunities. Big said, listen, you could do the same thing with me, I'm going to be happy. And the rest became history. So when you create a track record and you start proving yourself, the opportunity is going to start coming to you. But you got to be ready to pounce on those opportunities and you got to keep proving yourself. Because let's say Puff started working with Big and his career never blew up. He never became that good. Well, that's a hit on his track record, right? So you got to make sure you keep proving yourself with every opportunity that you get, whether you got to work for somebody else, whether you got to take a job that's unpaid, whether you got to do something you think is beneath you, something that you think you're too good for. These are the things that you do to build your track record if you don't already have one. And that's how you convince people of anything. Work on your game. DreAllDay.com.